Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that, we are studying topic significance of respiration. Significance is nothing but importance of respiration. We all know that three cycles take place in respiration. Let's try and find out what is the importance of these three cycles. During the respiration process, what happens is your Krebs cycle, your glycolytic cycle, deoxidative carboxylation of pyruvate or pyruvic acid, as well as your ETS cycle. Now all this together consists of nothing but respiration process. And during every respiration process, there is some amount of ATP that's formed. In some cases it is more, in some cases it is less. Even high energy molecules like NADPH2 and FADPH2 are broken. Now some compounds like CO2, H2O is liberated. Especially in respiration, the CO2 or the H2O that's liberated is used in photosynthesis process. Students, respiration helps to convert, or it does metabolically breakdown of food material. It converts food into such metabolic or simpler products that can be used. Respiration conserves much more energy than any other man-made food, especially glycolysis if we say. It conserves 64 kilocal of energy. Coupled with photosynthesis, if you talk about respiration, it helps to maintain the carbon dioxide balance. Now, photosynthesis uses carbon dioxide as a source of raw material, whereas your respiration removes carbon dioxide as a byproduct. So now if respiration removes carbon dioxide as byproduct and water as well, now this carbon dioxide as a byproduct removed by respiration can be used by photosynthesis as a raw material to synthesize glucose. Remember the equation CO2 plus H2O in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll to form glucose? Over there it can be used. Significance of respiration. Now when I talk about the significance of respiration, it converts food materials, that is carbohydrates, proteins, fats, into metabolically usable forms by the process of catabolism and anabolism. Respiration can conserve much more energy than any other man-made fuel, especially the process of glycolysis. Now when you couple photosynthesis along with respiration, what we notice is that the carbon cycle, when I say carbon cycle, it means the intake and the usage of carbon dioxide in nature. We all know that plants use carbon dioxide as a byproduct for the process of photosynthesis. So now this carbon dioxide has to be given back to the nature in some form, and that is done by the process of respiration. So photosynthesis uses carbon dioxide as a food source or to prepare food material, whereas respiration gives carbon dioxide as a raw material, or you can say it gives back carbon dioxide to the nature during its byproduct. When we talk about anaerobic fermentation, during anaerobic fermentation, what happens is that a number of products that are formed during anaerobic fermentation or fermentation in the absence of oxygen can be used as commercially important products. Now, one of them is alcohol, and which is ethyl alcohol. Especially antibiotics like streptomycin, erythromycin, all those can be used. Even vitamins like B12, colbamine, vitamin C, vitamin A that are synthesized chemically by anaerobic fermentation are of great importance. The intermediate product or the product that are formed in the latent phases during the respiration process, whether it is organic products or respiration products which are aerobic or anaerobic, are used to the synthesis of organic compounds like fats and proteins. Especially during the formation of protein polypeptide chain, when amino acids are linked together, the proteins like arginine and methionine, serine may use these organic compounds. Fats which are unsaturated, monosaturated or disaturated, polysaturated fats may use these organic compounds for forming the peptide linkage or forming the peptide linkage in proteins as well as the fatty acid linkage in fats. So students, what we came through in this part of the chapter was the significance or the importance of respiration. Now respiration as a whole team of glycolysis, Krebs cycle, ETS, decarboxylic decomposition or breakdown of pyruvic acid, totality helps and forms respiration, and every other process or step or cycle has some importance, and in total after the process of photosynthesis the respiration process takes place, which add various benefits to the cell system or the cell cycle. Now photosynthesis is in analogy with the process of respiration. Once photosynthesis is done, then decarboxylation breakdown of pyruvic acid is done, and then your respiration whole process or the whole cycle is done, and every other step generates certain amount of ATP, certain amount of NADPH2 and certain amount of ADP in the form of high energy molecule. I hope students, you all are very clear about this concept of significance of respiration. Thank you.